Double life led by this former Wyoming County Sheriff's deputy led to a murder. Today, police and prosecutors laid out a clearer picture of the story of Joseph Milnick, who just yesterday pleaded guilty to killing a friend. Channel 2's Jeff Preval has the shocking new details.
Joseph Milnick is behind bars in Wyoming County and could spend the rest of his life in prison after admitting to shooting and killing his friend Robert Irvine III in March. Milnick's defense attorney says the two at one point had a romantic relationship. At a press conference today, the Wyoming County DA and sheriff revealed details of their investigation into Milnick's double life, saying as a former sheriff's deputy and Perrytown board member, he groomed young men for sex.
It was clear from meeting with numerous witnesses that throughout the past 20 years, Milnick had used his position as deputy or sergeant with the Wyoming County Sheriff's Office either to seek out possible troubled young men by either meeting them at the scene of an incident that they were involved in, helping them out with a charge, or speaking with them at the jail.
In December of last year, state police received an allegation of possible sexual assault by Milnick.
The allegation was not a viable claim due to the statute of limitations that currently existed at the time.
They say Milnick for months was concerned about that allegation getting out.
On March 6, 2018, a conversation between Robbie and Joe Milnick ensued regarding the sexual abuse allegations that had been made against Milnick. According to Milnick, Robbie told him that night that he was going to tell them, the police, what Milnick did to him.
The next day, Milnick shot Irvine in Milnick's driveway and called 911 to report what happened. The DA's office says there are at least 5 sex assault accusations against Milnick, but they can't be corroborated.
And as part of that plea, we also agreed to not prosecute him for any potential charges that the Wyoming County DA's office was aware of.
And Milnick will be sentenced next month and has agreed to a sentence of 15 years to life in prison. And the DA hopes that the parole board keeps him there for life. Now, I talked to Milnick's defense attorney, who says that he doesn't dispute the timeline laid out by the DA. And he says that part of the reason Milnick pleaded guilty was to prevent any embarrassment of hearing witnesses talk about his double life. I'm Jeff Preval, Channel 2 News.